A very good morning, class. We are in the chapter number 14, Natural Disaster. Chapter number 14, Natural Disaster. And we have already seen what is a natural disaster, what are the causes of natural disaster, and what are the types we are discussing. The first one we have discussed about the earthquake. What is an earthquake? What are the causes of earthquake? And how can earthquake be overcome, or how can we decrease the chances of earthquake? We have even talked about the scale which is used for measuring the effect of earthquake, or the scale which measures the effect of earthquake. Today we have to start with the second type of natural disaster, that is a volcano. Since we are in the revision part, we have already covered this chapter. I'll give you a small introduction about this. What is a volcano, the meaning, and how does it occur? What are the causes of volcanoes? Basically, a volcano is a vent on Earth's surface. Vent means a small open area or a small gap in the Earth's surface through which molten rocks, gases and steam comes out. Why does it come out? Because there is a collision inside the Earth, the mantle part. There is a collision of the different molten rocks. They collide with each other, and the collision effect is so high that they come out from wherever they get the space. So these space or these vents between the earth give them the space to come out. The crust or the mantles collide with each other at such a high speed. The speed is so high that the collision takes place and they burst out of the from beneath the earth, and they come out in the form of lava. Lava is again a hot substance which comes out of the collision of the different mantles or the rocks or the molten parts, and slowly, steadily they assemble into a big mountain shape. That is why it is called as volcanic eruptions, or mountainous volcanoes are formed. Means the eruption, when it takes place, it takes the shape of a mountain. It erupts in the form of a mountain. From the hole or from the vent of the earth, the lava comes out and it blows into the air, and it takes the shape of a mountain. That is why these are even known as volcanic mountains. Volcanic mountains means the volcanoes which look like the mountains, which they are actually not a mountain, but they look like a mountain. Slowly and steadily, these mountains or these volcanic eruptions which are assembled at one place, they fall down, they stabilize themselves and they fall down on the surface of the earth into a solid form. I can show you just a diagram of it, just a picture of it. This is a volcanic eruption. This is a volcanic eruption which comes out and the lava get assembled into the atmosphere, and slowly and steadily it falls down and all the solid parts are separated. So the main reason for the volcanic eruption is the collision. The collision which takes place inside the earth, and wherever they get this space, they come out. Okay, so lava takes this shape. Lava is basically a hot matter which takes the shape of the mountain when they erupt out of the surface of the earth. They assemble in one place and they take the shape of a volcanic mountain. So these have even some advantages. The advantages of volcanic eruptions are, or the advantages of volcanoes are, that some good materials which were hidden inside the earth, they come out.
the materials which were hidden inside the earth, which we were not able to take it out, which we were not able to discover. During the volcanic eruption time, some good materials are discovered, and those materials can be used for different purposes, for different developmental activities. So this is one of the best benefit of volcanic eruptions. Whenever an eruption takes place, it actually gives us, blesses us with some good materials which are required for the different preparation of different items, different things. And these materials, since they were unused, they were hidden inside the earth, they are in the raw form, which actually can be very helpful to the human mind. So this is about the volcanoes, the meaning of volcanoes. I'll just read the definition. A volcano is a vent in the earth's crust through which molten rocks, gases and steam pours their way out to the surface of the earth. A volcano is an important internal agent of change. Internal agent of change it is considered. Why? Because all the changes that are taking place, or all the eruptions that take place, is all due to the volcanoes only. The different materials erupted by volcanoes accumulate and form a volcanic mountain. All the materials that come out of the surface of the earth, they accumulate at one point and they are called as volcanic mountains. So class, this was about the meaning of the volcanoes. In the next class, we shall talk about the causes and the types of volcanoes. Thank you, class.